Now moving back to Web3, but more on the financial side, let me share with you my personal experience. And in no way I'm a Web3 expert like Emmanuel. I'm just trying to tell you how it looks like. So I'm going to take you to three different steps. Why Web3 initiatives are important nowadays, what we can do in Luxembourg, and you know, a concrete example around this fund called CVP No Limits is run by an ex-CSO of Binance Holdings. So if you look at the web trend, and you have the presentation before, you know, the search for Web3 has increased tremendously for the past few months, and therefore there's a lot of noise about it going forward. I'm not going to tell you what is Web3 because Emmanuel before did share with you what is Web3. So let's go that you all know by now that Web3 is the next generation using blockchain, and a lot of companies are moving from Web2 to Web3. And let me share with you what we look at, right? So I'm not an expert, but I've been asked to create a European hub for investors and or GPs or VCs in Luxembourg looking at Web3. So that was my task going forward, and I have a call from this guy from Binance early on. So I didn't know what is exactly, you know, so I look at venture maps. You know, the VCs are very good to tell you what is happening out there. So I look at this first map, which is a Coinbase map. So Coinbase is the Bloomberg of you know, cryptocurrency, and they give you this, you know, so obviously you don't understand much because you have to be in that kind of world, because protocol layers, you know, infrastructure layers and so on and so forth are mainly technical terms, right? So if I want to simplify this, you can see at the bottom, if you use Android, you have Android operating system, infrastructure is, you may have Google One use case, you may have apps or Google Play Store and access layer, you may have different, you know, applications from third party. So if you look at this from the European finance point of view, it's not gonna help you. So let's look at another example, right? So now you move to more, on the developer side, or the Bitcoin map, which is more about how you make money. And you know, you can see here that a lot of people are looking into those investment domains. You have Web3, you know, we talk about it. Gaming, Emmanuel talked about it. NFT, the same thing. But you can see there's a lot of people looking at, on the upper left, DeFi, right? Decentralized finance, which is mainly what this conference is talking about. So how to develop that. There's a case in Luxembourg about Fund DLT doing blockchain to mix, to connect asset manager with investors or insurance, life insurance. And that's, you know, one example. So you learn more that here, there's something going on with the technical side from the previous map, and there's a lot of things going around DeFi. If you want to go further into the technical part, you then look at TechCrunch. Those are very much a map for tech or developers. You can see that it looks very differently, right? They look at more features or things that can be done for you. But of course, if you're coming from the financial institutions like here, it doesn't mean anything as well, right? So it's stopped there. Now, last one. From a VC point of view, Speed Invest, it's a VC. They divide into two words, you know. The left is more how you make money with that, and the right is more how you create content with that. So another way, but it doesn't help me as well, right? So we came up with our own map as well, because we start to learn about all those maps, connecting with all the startups, you know, 200-300 startups around that, to learn about what is Web3. And we start to also do the own map just to have a better understanding. So I'm not going to comment, because this is more a synthesis of the other maps. But what I found interesting going forward after the Web3 is that with a delegation of 100 people, we went to the Web Summit. Have you heard of the Web Summit, anyone? In this room? Okay. So, you know, at the Web Summit, there's the Luxembourg delegation, about 100 people came there, and we discussed about all the technology that will impact the web going forward, and how people from Web 2 are going to Web 3. Over 300 conferences in 4 days. There's about 100 conferences on Web3, right, or metaverse, or crypto, or blockchain, and so on. So 1/3 of the content this year of the Web Summit, and you can learn from different people at the delegation, that it was around Web3. So there is a lot of things going on out there. It's coming to Luxembourg because a few people here are interested in that. I'm not sure if they are here today, about one or two, but there is something going on up here. So I'm not going to, we can discuss more about during lunchtime about what can be done here. But let me share with you one particular personal experience about this guy that I met, right? So CVP No Limits. If you play poker, you will relate to the word No Limits, but this guy that I met, he used to play poker with CZ back in China, in Shanghai, in the apartment, just before when CZ created Binance. He sold CZ his apartment for 700, put everything in Bitcoin, lost about 40% of the value the next day, still, you know, managed to launch it. And this guy was working and playing with him poker, and he joined Binance at the beginning of the creation just to become the chief strategy officer. So what does he mean, strategy officer? You know, a lot of stuff. But one thing that he did very well, he was in charge of Binance Labs. And Binance Labs is the kind of VC arm of Binance since today. So he then launched Binance. So you probably heard about Binance, and you probably heard more about Binance with FTX and FTX is like the Lehman Brothers back in 2008 that helped, you know, JP Morgan to be stronger. So there is a big crash, a big crypto winter right now. But back to the launch of Binance, you can see that Binance reached 1 billion profit in less than 6 months. So it was the number one growth company in the history to reach 1 billion profit in 6 months. Just to give you the scale, they have, I think there's about 150 billion of trading on a daily basis, and Binance is about 2/3. They have about 100. So they own 65% of market share today. And also this guy, Jin, chief strategy officer, and also at the board of Binance US, you know, said to me, you know, I've done something and I would like to replicate it, you know. And these are my investments during the crypto winter, right? It was back in 2018, 2019, which is more or less the same cycle as today. And he makes of an investment with this thinking, okay, he look at developers, so the people who are looking at the tech companies. He put some, you know, small tickets, so seed tickets, you can see, less than 1 million. And he target only companies that are going for ICOs with a community within 1 to 2 years, right? So that's his pure strategy, looking at crypto winter, looking at developers launching ICOs and within 1 to 2 years. And so he did that for a few companies, a few of them are here, and those are the returns that he had. So, you know, so when I look at that, I was just wondering, is it right or not? But I make some due diligence, and actually it is true. He has made those stuff. So looking at what he has done, he has done 40 in investment. 32 of them were under his management over 2 years, doing a crypto winter. And then he actually deployed 35 million and then sold for 1.8 billion. So the IRR, if you want, was 50x, right? In this world, when I have 5x from an investment of VCs, I'm very happy, right? 50x, I never seen it. And today the norm for Web3 is 10x. So he's outperformed his category. And he said to me, okay, now what I've done at Binance, I want to do it, you know, outside Binance, right? Binance, for the story, with that kind of stuff, have launched from 500 million fund this year, going forward. And so he moved out and he started to create a global fund, looking at all the initiative from developers, not from, you know, so those are the deals that you don't find if you are looking from here. you need to be located in Los Angeles, Singapore, China, and so on. So he has a team looking at those deals, trying to look at developers, trying to launch ICOs within 2 years, and he just invests 500K on average, seed investors. It's interesting because as a VC, when you invest, usually you have the return of 5 to 10 years. Those guys are looking into investment with a return over 2 years. And since an ICO is become pretty liquid, so it's a kind of new VC, like VC 3.0 on Web 3.0. So learning a lot from this guy. And so for us, it's interesting because we have here a guy who has connection worldwide with a lot of initiatives that you and I will not be able to access it. Many developers, so very, you know, below the radar, nothing around Crunchbase, nothing about, you know, CB Insider, whatever database that you are looking at, none of the things are here, none of the guys actually hanging out here, right? So it's actually completely invisible for us, but yet he has managed to access a few deals. He made the investment, and then he told us, we would like to globalize and have a presence in Europe. We would like to convince investors to join and so on. And then can you establish, you know, like a European headquarters in Luxembourg for us? So that's what we did. We make a hub here. We look at investors that are mainly entrepreneurs or family offices investing to a life insurance, you know, from the Lux life insurance, just to clarify the path. And that's what's the story I have for you, all right? So the key message is here is that I'm looking for an auditor. No, the key message here is that I'm telling you that Web3, it's not something that is outside this world. It's actually right here. You can actually assess a lot of interesting things, and you can talk to those guys if you want to later on. That's it. Thank you.